These British bikers are on a 350-mile journey, which will finish here at Wimbledon. They've undergone the grueling three-day trek with one goal in mind, to keep the memory of one of Britain's tennis stars burning brightly.
You know, if you have a dream, it's, you know, it's fantastic, and if you really want to be a professional tennis player, then go for it.
My nickname is Bally. I remember someone actually just calling me Bally when I was 14 on one of the junior trips that I went away with. And it's quite funny because even my mum calls me Bally now, so when someone calls me Elena, I have to do a double take, really. Tell us about your greatest victory. I've had three. I've beaten three top 10 players. I did that in 2010. And I had such a great year.
Bally was fearless, like the big matches against the big players. No, she loved tennis. She absolutely loved it, and everything that was attached to it as well. If I'm being honest, coaching Bally was a dream. It was the happiest day of my life, and I know it was the happiest day of Bal's life as well. I'm just so pleased we managed to get married before this horrific nightmare. You know, it was, I don't know what I would have done if that didn't happen. The diagnosis was on the 17th of January, to the very last day. There was never any giving up, even when it was looked hopeless. It was a privilege to be by her side. Bally had a plan, you know, that's what she left me with. She left me with all the conversations, all her ideas, all her visions, all her dreams, all her plans, all the things we talked about. And she left me with that, and that's what I try and do now, and that's what she did then. She took away the barriers, the limitations for a lot of people to play tennis who didn't have money. And I'm really proud that we can continue that.
I think she would be overjoyed. Her philosophy when she started the academy many years ago, when she was British number one, she was at the top of her game, and that I think says so much about her that, you know, even with a very, very hectic schedule and the demands on her personally and professionally, she was creating this academy which gave little girls in particular the chance to try tennis in the more disadvantaged areas of where she lived in Ipswich. One of the many fundraisers that's going on is Ride for the Roof, which two friends and great supporters of Bally's who are riding bikes to raise money. Fingers crossed that they'll get there this weekend, but just a great example of two people who love Bally and just getting on their bikes.
We both discussed at a trustees meeting that we should do something, and we thought the cycle ride, the 350 miles, would be a good thing that we could contribute. And we thought, well, going to the tennis venues during the grass court season was unique and very much relevant to her life and all of the, you know, areas where she's done really well.
When we hit the heels, it's just, we've got to do it, you know, we attack it the same way that Bally attacked her opponent.
We've found as well, when you're doing a ride for sort of somewhere between 6 and 10 hours, you have your dark moments, rather like in a game of tennis where the momentum shifts. You do get into the mindset of, well, what would it be like in a long three-set match, and how would she handle it? And obviously we think about her when we're struggling and know that, you know, she was so brave towards the end of her illness that this is the least we can do.
Well done.
I think she'd be proud of us.
She's with us.
I always want to make Bal proud, and when I see that, I know that is because of Bal. So many children in tennis that would never have joined our sport if it wasn't for my wife.
To learn more about the Elena Baltacha Tennis Academy, check out our Open Court Facebook page, where we've linked information about the Ride for the Roof campaign.
Thanks, Pat.
Well done, mate. Thank you.